Hi there, it's Marlene Helema from ImageMaven.com, and today we're going to talk about keeping your stuff clean. So let's talk about keeping your lenses clean. So last week we talked about protection, and you know, I have my lens hood on, and hopefully you've thrown away that UV filter. So here's our lens, and let's say that it has a little bit of dust on it. Well, all you have to do is blow it off. Now, the best way to blow it off is with one of these blower bulbs, okay? Squeeze them, air comes out. Nice, clean air. So you just blow it on the surface, and dust is gone. If you have smudges, you might need a little more power. What I use is one of those cleaning cloths that you use for eyeglasses. However, I don't put them anywhere near my eyeglasses, because I don't know about your eyeglasses, but I wear mine outside a lot. And there's little pieces of grit on it, a little bit of nose grease. Yeah, I know that's gross. But anyway, if you have a little smudge, you just rub it dry, okay? And if the smudge doesn't come off, okay, I do this very, very technical thing, this process, and it's called... Ooh, very scary. Don't get into trouble with that one. There you go. My lens, super duper clean. So very simple. A little bit of air, a little bit of power. That's all I do. I keep this little cloth in this airtight container. In fact, it's an old film canister. Isn't that cool? Back in the day from Kodak. If you don't have one of these left from your film days, you can just put it in a small Ziploc bag. But the key is not to get it dirty and not to use it on anything else, except your camera lenses. So we've cleaned our lens. Now what do we do if we notice sensor dust? And sensor dust will show up on your photos, usually in areas that don't have a lot of detail in them, like the sky or some solid color. If you have sensor dust and it won't come off with the built-in sensor cleaner, you're going to have to use some help. There's three things you can do. You can blow the air off your sensor, you can pull it off using static, or you can scrub it off using something called a PEC pad. First off though, you have to have access to your sensor. And to do that, you need to go into the camera menus. You go into the menu called sensor cleaning. And what that does, it flips the mirror up out of the way so that you have clear view of the sensor. And the first thing you want to do is blow off any possible dust. And I like to hold the camera like this so that after I blow in, the dust will hopefully fall out if there's any kind of gravity at all. If that didn't work, you have to go to plan B. And of course you have to take photos in between each of your cleaning sessions to see if you got rid of the dust. Now this is called a sensor brush. And it's a very fine haired brush. What you do with this is you blow it with your bulb. You blow it with the air. And what that does is it statically charges the brush. Because most of the dust on your sensor is there because of static. And then you drag the brush across your sensor once. And then if you want, you could do it again. Blow off the dust that you've just picked up and swipe the sensor again. At this point, I would take a few more test photos to see if you got rid of your dust. Most dust is from static. One of the reasons you get dust on your sensor is because you remove your lenses without turning your camera off, and inside your camera, when the power's on, it's statically charged. Did you ever rub a balloon on your head at a birthday party? You can stick it to the wall. That's how strong static charges are. So most of the dust from your sensor comes from that. And as a last resort, you can buy these alcohol swabs, and they come with a little alcohol fluid, and you squeeze it on. This has got a little swab wrapped around it. You squeeze it on and you swipe it over your sensor. I've only had to do this once in my in the life of this particular camera. And usually it only happens if there's some sort of moisture involved. If you're very careful with your camera and lenses, like I tend to be, you probably won't have to use one of these very much. But if you work in very adverse conditions, you work in rain and wet conditions quite a lot, you may find yourself with a very dirty sensor, where a brush alone will not help you clean it. So having clean camera gear is very important if you want professional results with your photography. You don't want to spend time in Photoshop cleaning up the messes that you made on your actual camera gear. So again, I recommend a blower brush as a really good accessory for your kit. If you're going to clean your lens, you can blow off the dust or use a clean anti-static cloth to wipe it. If you have sensor dust, you can use a dry sensor brush or one that has alcohol on it. There's a company called visibledust.com, and they make these sensor brushes that I've been telling you about. They also make one called the Arctic Butterfly, where you don't actually need the blower bulb to statically charge the brush. So don't forget, protection and cleanliness will give you better results in your digital photography. Thanks for watching. It's Marlene Hielema from ImageMaven.com. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so, and give me a thumbs up on this video. I really appreciate your support. Thanks again.